waitress from New York City, dude. What do you think? Do you think I know how to do any of this stuff? You know, like, I'm not trying to be a monk here. Like, I'm tired. I want to go sit back with a lemonade. Like, I don't really want to be, like, bowing 37 times. And we bowed for, like, days. I swear to God, we were there forever.
It looks like the big guy upstairs is providing. What's with you, Todd?
I'm a flight attendant.
You're a flight attendant? No way.
I am, yeah.
You were so cute.
Sorry, I am equally irritated. I seem to be, like, sort of marooned in a land of, like, flight attendants and Sunday school teachers. Like, come on. I live in a city. Like, people who live in New York don't act like this.
All right, let's do this.
Yeah, stay long.
This is, like, my own private hell. There's, like, exactly the kind of people that, like, I don't like being around, who are all, like,
everything's always great. Isn't it amazing? Like, you're doing a really good job with that.
Any guy who shows up to a game that throws you out into the middle of the jungle in a silk shirt and no underpants, you gotta wonder about that. Alright, Jean Robert snoring goes something like this. John Robert, we all know, he's like the D student of our tribe. He won't do anything. He gets up and then instantly has to go lay down because he's so tired.
We don't like each other.
You're not right about that.
Oh, well, you like me and I don't like you.
There you go.
Okay.
John Robert and Aaron got into a ridiculous bitch fight and we were all just like, in front of the spy? Really? Are you just gonna give her a map of who doesn't like who? Like, can we not, like, have a little solidarity for, like, 2 seconds while she's here?
Let's go around
you know
the camp and ask who's doing a good job.
It's been real, and it's been fun, but it hasn't been real fun.
I just can't stand all the Brady Bunch antics that go on in this tribe. Aaron stood up this morning, put on his little suit and jacket with his little powwow. Like, some of us haven't even taken our head up off the bamboo yet.
I need to be warm.
Look. When you stop snuggling so much, can you scan the girl?
I do get kind of a creep vibe from Jean Robert, and so does Amanda. Neither one of us likes him. I'm sure has noticed that she and I will both go to great pains to not be next to him in the shelter, and yet he will just climb in there, and he's like, I need Amanda and Courtney by my side. You know, they keep me warm. Like, I'm going to keep anyone warm? I weigh 7 pounds. I can't even keep myself warm. Get off of me.
I let Todd take the charge, and he was doing it, and it looked like he was doing just fine for a while.
Now Jean Robert is spinning it that Todd didn't do the puzzle right, so it's always someone else besides him. But, like, I don't care. I'll vote for snore-faced Jean Robert just because he annoys the crap out of me.
Don't touch that.
I'm touching it and it's not that hot.
Stop. Okay, sorry. I was afraid it might be hot.
I really don't like when you yell at me like that.
I was trying to protect you.
I know that you think you're just raising your voice, but I don't like when you yell at me. And I'm not getting mad at you, so you don't need to get huffy. Waking up with Jean Robert still here is just how I knew it would be. He's like a cocky son of a bitch, and he sucks so bad, there's no getting out of that.
That was like a cautionary, like, careful.
I understand,
right.
But just so you know where I'm coming from, I have a gut reaction that I don't like anyone raising their voice to me. I don't give a crap who goes next as long as it's not me. I would prefer it be Jean Robert because he's just so unpleasant and he gets in my face with no matter what I say. He's like just aggressive with me and I'm sick of it. Since I sat at the reward challenge, that means I have to compete in the immunity challenge.
Uh-oh.
I am practicing a lot because, you know, what can you do? You're given a thing and you're said to practice. Like, you have to prepare. You can't just walk out there like and be like, oh.
You were doing just fine. Just swing it above your head and aim at something. Baby doll, that's your worst of them all.
I'm under no disillusions that I'm going to be like the star of the team.
Beautiful.
I'll probably be eating my words, but maybe it is for small people today. Maybe it's for, because it looks like little David and Goliath, like sweet slingshot, you know? Like little Todd in his bandana looks really cute, slinging the little.
I'm ready to go. I'm ready. Yo, when I compete, it's on.
Jamie was like a little blob doll with her little boobies and her hot pink bikini, and she bartends at a frat house and she's like, can I order you online? Like, aren't there ads for you in the back of a magazine somewhere? Like, just come on.
I believe that the USA hockey team is missing a player.
I won't lie to you, Frosty and James. That tub looks the most attractive to jump in right now. That tub right
I am so happy right now.
I tried my best to be as far away from Jean Robert in the bathtub as could possibly happen in that place. He had the one on the far end. I took the one on the other far end. He's kind of gross. Every single part of me wants to see Jean Robert go. I just don't like him. He's a horrible person.
All right, so we're in agreement for Sharia tonight, huh?
Yeah. So after Todd and Amanda's plans went awry, they're like, okay, well, no question about it, we're voting off Sharia, okay? Sharia. And I'm like, yeah, okay, whatever. But then after thinking about it for a little while, I actually like Sharia. And if it came down to it of who I thought would vote me out quicker, I definitely think that she would keep me around longer than Jean Robert.
You guys have a tiff, and if you guys resolve it, that's what you guys can do. If not, then not, you know?
Jean Robert, he's horrible to me. He's not nice to me. They suck up to him. Even the two people who want to be, like, my friends, Todd and Amanda. I don't feel like I really need to be anybody's friend in this game. I dislike everyone else more than I dislike Todd and Amanda. I think they mistake that for friendship. Oh my God, we get to see it.
Yeah.
We go in and we sit down at the table. And I was pretty pumped because boo challenges. Yay, feast.
Look how many dips there are.
Food. Sweet and sour pork, you guys.
Beef. They brought in 5 vegetarian dishes, 5 meat dishes.
Oh.
And we also got several choices of alcoholic beverage, which I enjoyed. I thought it was quite nice.
PG is on a crusade to be the most annoying person here at camp. The position's already filled. We have Jean Robert. We have the annoying person. Why don't you be something else? She's now started the world's longest campaign of a pity party, and anytime I see her coming, I walk away.
I went into the challenge thinking, okay, well, we can't let her win immunity, because then it's going to send everyone into a tailspin. And then when she fell in the water, I was like, well, now I can fall in the water, but I don't want to fall in the water.
There you go, Courtney.
Thank you.
That was a tough one, too.
Well, I don't like getting wet. I did win immunity today. I didn't think I would ever win anything. So I pretty much don't care at this point who gets voted out. I'm immune tonight, so can't get me.
That barrel didn't even fudge, did it?
Nope. Well, I don't know. I mean, it's up to you guys. I don't give a crap. I'm not entirely sure what happened, but all of a sudden, Todd decided to vote for Jean Robert.
I think our best bet is Jean Robert tonight.
Jean Robert? Yeah.
It's a widely known fact that Jean Robert and I have hated each other since day one. So if everyone's finally willing to vote him out, then great. But he's become the Susan Lucci of Tribal Council. Like, his name is always up there, but he never quite gets voted out. So I don't have much faith that it will actually happen.
Everyone, it's Christmas! There's no Jean Robert in the fish!
Camp life without Jean Robert is much nicer. And I think that everyone else is also kind of happy to have him gone. Jean Robert is such a complainer and demanding people to fetch him things and it's just generally unpleasant. Denise was like shooting daggers at myself and Amanda because she was mad. By blindsiding Jean Robert, we had to blindside her too. And it could come back to get us.
I love my Frosty.
I don't really understand my relationship with Frosty. He's young, he's only 20. And he's kind of cute. He just wants to play.
I love our reward.
James and Denise are scared to death that you would not be willing to vote against Frosty.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
Because he's kind of like my survivor boyfriend.
Yes, and would you?
Frosty's kind of like my little munchkin. And, you know, everyone's kind of worried about me because they know that he's, you know, like my good friend.
You've seen him compete. I love the kid, but we don't have a choice, right?
We'll see how it goes. It really does, like, strategically make a difference whether or not, you know, I go with the group on this one or I don't go with the group on this one. So I don't know. I mean, honestly, I don't know who I'll vote for.
The cool woman after that gave us cookies.
You're lying. With chocolate?
No, like, they were like pecan candies.
I was about to push you back in the mud.
The cave is the best thing I have right now. The cave is my happy place. What I don't like is when everyone and their damn mother decides that they like the cave too. It's like, you know, PG comes sidling up in there. And I'm like, I'm gonna kill you. And then you wanna start talking about stuff? No, get out of here. Get out, no talking in the cave.
I could not believe that he, like, oh, my sister had an unplanned teenage pregnancy and then a convenient miscarriage. Gee whiz. Like, you think the girl might not want the entire world to know about that.
Like, if it's true, my deepest condolences to his family, but,
no,
like,
I thought the same thing.
I mean, I was
like, oh,
really?
How convenient. And then he was the first one picked by Denise.
Todd was going for the Oscar with his performance of My Sister Had a Convenient Miscarriage. And then, of course, Jeff was like, Todd, it looks like you just got some bad news. What happened? And Todd's like, my sister, she was pregnant and she lost the baby, but it happened for a reason. Like, that is not like the fake Johnny Fairplay, My Grandma Died. You can almost forgive that. That's funny.
At least PG will hopefully be weak.
She will also be filled with hatred.
Yeah, exactly.
It was sort of a strategic thing to have Denise bring Todd instead of Amanda to this, because Amanda is a lot less likely to stir up trouble back at camp than Todd would be. An angry Todd is a bad Todd.
And I think I could lose big time against you. Does that make sense? Which should be a huge, like, upstool for you.
We want PG out because she's been such a strong competitor, and she's a fighter, and she's succeeding, and we all have to admire it, and the jury will admire it too, and not one of us heinous bitches would stand a chance against her in a final three. So she would win. She has to go.
Courtney, the waitress.
I went in calling myself the absolute biggest long shot, and I still think I'm the longest shot to win it, but the fact that I've made it this far is insane.
Congratulations.
I'm like in shock. I thought I would be out in 16th place, so here I am, guaranteed at least 1 in 4 of winning.
We are final four on Survivor freaking China.
A pack of four bitches.
Oh my god.
I love us.
I've always sort of slipped through the cracks to get to the top. So hopefully I can continue to slip through.
The four of us were the, like, you know, the bottom of the totem pole from the beginning.
Exactly.
The immunity challenge that we have left, we'll have to see what it is. If it's something that I can pull off, then, I mean, that would be a great way to go to the final three with, you know, the immunity necklace.
Who do you think has the best chance right now of winning the jury?
Amanda or Courtney?
So, there you go. I mean, there's two people to get rid of that at least have a chance of getting more votes than either one of us.
Mm-hmm. Believe me, I've thought about it.
Todd and Denise were laying in the shelter, and I heard them talking, and I heard my name. So I just kind of sat there and listened to them talk.
I'm bugged by the fact that I've built relationships with all of you guys, and I hope it doesn't ruin whoever's name I have to write down.
Right.
Todd, I think, is a slippery little sucker and always has been. He does hold a lot of the cards. And he always manages to weasel his way into something. So whether it's half of a pizza or a seat in the top three, like, you can count on Todd. He will not look out for you. He does not care. He is looking out for himself.
Perfect. We made it. We're cooking in the jungle.
China's been a crazy experience for me. I'm glad that, you know, China was as hard as it was. Like, it rained. It was so hot. You know, it is like a building experience.
Cheers to the final three, girls.
Whoever would have thought.
No one.
Not me.
I'm proud of myself, and I can't believe it. Like, my final goal was to make the final three, and I did.
Can you guys believe that we made it this far?
No.
The three of us, really.
I'm so happy it's you guys, too.
Me too.
Now I'm getting sappy, too. I think I do have really good personal relationships on the jury. I have never been anything but my own winsome personality that has been called every name in the book since day one. So hopefully that'll get some credit. I made it this far, and that should get some respect from some people.
And you?
Yeah, I'm going to put you in the show,
bye. Oh, good idea.
Amanda and Todd really were my best friends throughout this whole experience. We've all been together since day one in the rain and the swamp. And, you know, I'm just really glad that the final day is being shared with people I honestly care about.
We're done. I mean, that's it.
I'm sure tonight when we all march out with our torches for the final leave-taking of our camp, it's going to be a sad moment, and maybe even I will get choked up. Who knows? I tend to have a little soft spot every so often. Don't tell anyone.